Hello and welcome to day 25 of my Advent Code Series, the final day. So if you've missed any of the previous episodes and want to check those out, check out the playlist linked right up here and be sure to get subscribed to me so you don't miss any of my future videos. So we've gotten to the check-in desk, we've gotten our room key, but it doesn't work because the registration system is down. So we decide that we just want to get in now, so we are going to reverse engineer the handshake between the card and the door so that we can send our own commands. So how the handshake works is first, the card transforms a subject number, which is always 7, according to the card's secret loop size. So the secrets that the card and the door have are both a loop size, and how a transformation works is it sets a value to 1, and then for the number of times in the loop size, it sets the value to itself. It sets value, which starts as 1, to itself multiplied by the subject number, which is 7. And then it for when we're determining our public keys, and then it sets the value to the remainder after dividing it by this number right here. So we do that for both of the card and the door with the subject number 7 to get their public keys, and then they trade public keys, and the card transforms the door's public key by the card's loop size to get the encryption key, and the door does the same to get the encryption key as well. So we need to determine what the encryption key is from the two public keys. It gives a good idea of how to do this right here. This one really came down to reading comprehension. I would have solved this in minute probably if I knew how to read and actually parse this information, but it took me a while because I didn't quite do that. But I highly recommend you go ahead and give this a try, and I will jump into my code right now. So the first thing I do is when I read in the data, I go ahead and grab, I split these two lines and convert them both to integers and just return them as a list, which then down in our main, I read as just card pub and door pub, and then I read those as data. So then what we are going ahead and doing with that is this gets passed into our part one function here. So what our part one function is doing is it is finding our loop number for our door by calling find loop, which is this function up here on the door's public key. So how this works is find loop takes in a public key, and it essentially just counts how many times you have to go ahead and mutate a value starting at 1 until you get to that public key, which will determine what our loop size is for our door. So it goes ahead and does the transformation as described there, multiplying it by the subject number, which is 7, and then modulusing it by 20201227, and it just adds 1 to our loop counter, and then eventually we return how many times we had to loop through. So that will give us our loop value right there, and then we can go ahead and just call transformation on the door's loop size and the card's public key to go ahead and get our encryption key. So what transformation does is it takes a loop and a public key, it initializes a value at 1, and then just for it just runs this loop the number of times of the number that is our loop key, goes ahead, multiplies our value by our public key, and then modulizes it by that same value, and then at the end of that, once we're done, we go ahead and return our value, and that is pretty much going to be it. So then part one goes ahead and finishes just like that, and we return our encryption key, and we can jump into part two. Part two, we are in our thing. We notice we only needed 49 stars after all, and we can go ahead and we give our deposit, and we are done for the year. So I hope you enjoyed the Advent of Code series this year. I definitely had a lot of fun doing it and sharing it with you guys, and I will see you in my next video. Goodbye.